We in the media just love to focus on hot button issues like immigration, like the battle over health care, like the Mueller report, like race relations, gun control, terrorism, all important issues, all need to be covered, all tend to occupy a lot of media real estate. But there's one issue that I believe has always been the salient one, the decisive one in presidential elections, and that's the economy. That is, when the economy is good, an incumbent president tends to be reelected. Economy not so good, tends to be a one-termer. And right now, regardless of what your political views are, you've got to acknowledge the economy is just sort of on fire. We just set records for the S&P and the NASDAQ, so the stock market is booming. Unemployment is 4%. It's hovered around 3.8, 3.9, 4%. And when the numbers came in on Friday for first quarter growth, 3.2% blew away the estimates. Now, obviously, if you're a coal miner or you're working in a factory that is shutting down or moving production overseas or to Mexico, maybe you're not feeling that. But we have the tax cuts, and a lot of people think that didn't help them. And there are problems down the road. Economists predicting a slowdown in growth over the next year and huge deficits. The administration itself says $1 trillion a year or more. But right now, if you're Donald Trump and you're trying to make the case that you've been a good steward of the economy, it's really not very hard. And that creates a dilemma for the Democrats because they can't. It's harder to run against good times than it is when the economy is in the tank. They can't openly root for things to be bad or paint an unduly negative picture because that wouldn't quite resonate. And, you know, don't take my word for it. Celinda Lake, who's a veteran Democratic pollster, tells Politico the Democrats don't really have much of a national message now on the economy, and that could be disastrous in 2020. Now, it's also hard when there are 20 different candidates and they're all sort of carving up the pie in terms of how much attention they can get. But take Joe Biden as an example. Just got into the race. Yesterday, he did the kickoff speech in Pennsylvania. He is often said with much justification to have a certain connection to white working class voters in states like Michigan and Pennsylvania. Donald Trump won. If Biden were to be the nominee, could win them back, the Democrats would retake the White House. But what if most of those blue-collar workers are doing pretty well in the Trump economy? You know, whether the president deserves full credit or not is almost beside the point, because when you're the guy in the White House, you get blamed when things go bad, when the stock market goes down, when unemployment goes up, and you benefit from the opposite. History has shown this. When Bill Clinton won in 92, it's because the economy was slowly recovering from a recession under George H.W. Bush. When there was that Wall Street meltdown in 2008, obviously it helped Barack Obama. So things could change and other issues will be important. And Trump is struggling in the polls overall. When it comes to the economy, he has bragging rights right now. And the Democrats have to figure out a way to make some proposals and to talk about inequality, obviously. But it's much, much harder to do. And if they can't figure out what to do, well, it was James Carville who said, it's the economy, stupid.